There was a new neon text effect released with the last upgrade of Final Cut Pro, that's to version 10.6. While it seems obvious what this does to text, there are some tricks that will let you expand the effect, and also, as you'll see later in the video, the effect can also be added to objects. So let's look at the obvious effect when added to a title. The effect is found in the text category in the effects browser, and the quickest result will be to add it to an outline font. I've used Florence Sans outlines to show you, and if you want to see how other fonts react, just hover over them in the font selections. The effect can be adjusted with outer brightness, outer glow, inner brightness, and thin fonts also suit the effect. I've used Got a Light here, and a standard font can also benefit from the effect, and nothing's more standard than Gill Sans. And here it is with the effect off, and here it is turned on, and now with the outer glow increased, and with an outline added. And finally, for the text effects, let's look at a novelty font. I've used HVD Peace, and it's turned off. Now enable it. And let's show it with a black background. As I said in the beginning, you can also add the effect to objects. Let's look at the shape from the effects category in your generators. This is a standard generator that comes with Final Cut Pro, so you'll be able to try it out too. So drag it from the generators, and here it is without the effect, and here it is with the effect turned on. I've also added the effect to my red arrows that I use in all my tutorials, without the effect, and with it turned on. And you can see how it can be changed with the inner brightness slider. And finally, I've added the effect to one of the standard backgrounds, and that's rays. This also comes with Final Cut Pro as a standard background. Here it is without the effect, and now with it turned on. And if you're wondering how the flashing neon effect was done at the beginning of this video, well, I'll show you how it's done. As you'll no doubt have worked out in the past, I record my face to camera sections with a green screen. And in this case, in the edit, I added the neon effect behind me and in front of the background. And then I cut the title into even pieces by holding the B key and clicking in the title. Then I selected all the pieces except for the first and dragged to the right. And then with the command key down, I deselected the second section and dragged, then deselected the third section, and so on. Finally, to fade out the effect, I right-clicked on the last section and then selected Show Video Animation. Click the little chevron and drag the fader slider to the left. And now you can see what seemed like such a simple effect can do so many things. I hope you've learnt something useful, and if you have, please like, subscribe, and press the bell to be notified of new tutorials every Sunday.